Hi everyone. So today we're going to be reading Corduroy. And there's a little bear on the front. And he is picking up something. So we'll see what this book is about. And it's by Dawn Freeman, the author. Remember, the author is the person that writes the book. The illustrator is the person that draws the pictures. Corduroy. Corduroy is a bear who once lived in the toy department of a big store. Day after day, he waited with all the other animals and dolls for someone to come along and take him home. You see his face? He's waiting patiently. The store was always filled with shoppers buying all sorts of things, but no one ever seemed to want a small bear with green overalls. Then one morning, a little girl stopped and looked straight into Corduroy's bright eyes. "Oh, Mommy," she said, "look. There's the very bear I've always wanted." "Not today, dear," her mother sighed. "I've spent too much already. Besides, he doesn't look new. He's lost the button to one of his shoulder straps." Corduroy watched them sadly as they walked away. "I didn't know I'd lost a button," he said to himself. "Tonight I'll go and see if I can find it." Let's see what he's gonna do to go find it. There he is. He's getting off the shelf. Late that evening, when all the shoppers had gone and the doors were shut and locked, Corduroy climbed carefully down from his shelf and began searching everywhere on the floor for his lost button. Everybody search. Where could it be? He's looking and looking. Oh, do you guys know what those are called? Let's see if they have the word for it. Suddenly, he felt the floor moving under him. Quite by accident, he had stepped onto an escalator. And up he went. Could this be a mountain? He wondered. I think I've always wanted to climb a mountain. He stepped off the escalator as it reached the next floor. And there, before his eyes, was the most amazing sight. Tables and chairs and lamps and sofas and rows and rows and rows of beds. This must be a palace, Corduroy gasped. I guess I've always wanted to live in a palace. He wandered around, admiring the furniture. This must be a bed, he said. I've always wanted to sleep in a bed. And up he crawled onto a large, thick mattress. And there's the mattress. Oh, look what he's doing right there. All at once, he saw something small and round. Oh, why, there's my button, he cried. And he tried to pick it up, but like all the other buttons on the mattress, it was tied down tight. He yanked and pulled with both paws until pop, off came the button, and off the mattress Corduroy toppled. Bang into the tall floor lamp, over it fell with a crash. Corduroy didn't know it, but there was someone else awake in the store. The night watchman was going his rounds on the floor above. When he heard the crash, he came dashing down the escalator. There he is, he's coming down the escalator. He has his flashlight. "Now who in the world did that?" he exclaimed. "Somebody must be hiding around here." There's Corduroy. He's hiding. He flashed his light under and over sofas and beds until he came to the biggest bed of all. And there he saw two fuzzy brown eyes, ears, sticking up from under the cover. Saw the ears. "Hello," he said. "How did you get upstairs?" The watchman tucked Corduroy under his arm and carried him down the escalator and set him on the shelf in the toy department with the other animals and dolls. "Did he find his button?"
"No."
"Oh, look who came back to come visit him. Let's see what she does." Corduroy was just waking up when the first customers came into the store in the morning, and there, looking at him with a wide, warm smile, was the same little girl he'd seen only the day before. And look at her there. What do you think she's going to do? "I'm Misa," she said. "And you're going to be my very own bear. Last night I counted what I've saved in my piggy bank, and my mother said I could bring you home." So she got her money from her piggy bank, and her mom said, "Okay, we can go to the store and you can buy your bear." "Shall I put him in a box for you?" the sales lady asked. "Oh, no, thank you," Lisa answered, and she carried Corduroy home in her arms. She ran all the way up 4 flights of stairs into her family's apartment and straight to her own room. Oh, there she is in her room. Corduroy blinked. There was a chair and a chest of drawers and alongside a girl-sized bed stood a little bed, just the right size for him. The room was small, nothing like the enormous palace in the department store. "This must be home. Do you remember home?" he said. "I know I've always wanted a home." Lisa sat down with Corduroy on her lap and began to sew a button on his overalls. "I like you the way you are," she said, "but you'll be more comfortable with your shoulder strap fastened." So she's, look at that. She's putting a button on his overalls. Isn't that nice of her? She's saying, "You're going to be more comfortable with the button." "You must be a friend," said Corduroy. "I've always wanted a friend." "Me too," said Lisa, and she gave him a big hug. Make sure you're seeing it. That's it. Red Rover, Red Rover, my book is now over. Wasn't that a nice story? I love this book. When I was little, this was one of my favorite books. Parents and kids, if you guys are wanting to do maybe an activity, you can always look up. This is my daughter. You can always look up on Pinterest Corduroy activities. But you can also, what I would do is kind of put some buttons out and maybe put maybe green paper buttons and brown paper and let your kids explore with scissors and glue. And if you have any extra buttons around the house, maybe some in your sewing kit or whatever, allow them to make an art project, open-ended processed art. and they can make their own corduroy, they can make their own overalls, they can just make some type of art with buttons. You let allow them to explore, and hopefully they'll be engaged with that. I hope you guys liked our story, okay? Corduroy. We'll see you guys soon. Bye.